Okay, now we have to create the pluggable database and add different sample schema and then your pluggable database. What is the method? We are having the different method to create the pluggable database. One of them is we are having database configuration assistant. So using the database configuration assistant, we can create the pluggable database or we can manage the pluggable database. In that one pluggable database, we can add different type of sample schema also. Sample schema means we can add over there author, that can be added over there Scott and other users that are available by default. So now we will create the database, and that is a pluggable database. And that one pluggable database, we will say that we are having the different type of schemas are available that are built in. So first of all, if you want to check then what are the different pluggable database are available in our systems, how we can check? So for that one, start the SQL plus, and here username is here says as sysdba, password enter. Here we have to use it over here. The command, there is a show pdbs. What are the different pluggable databases are available in our systems? So we see that we are having, still now we are having pdb seeds. Next one, we are having the pdb over cl, pdb over cl1, over cl2, pdb over cl3. Three or four different pluggable databases are available over here in our systems. We want to create the new pluggable database using the database configuration assistant, although we can create it using the command prompt. Using the queries, we can create the pluggable database. We will discuss it later on. First, we can create the pluggable database using the database configuration assistant, and in over there we can add the different type of sample schema. Okay, now so how we can start the database configuration assistant? So for that one, in search options we can use it over here dbca. Over here in dbca, click it over here, so database configuration assistant command will be executed and the option of database configuration assistant will be displayed in front of you and few menu. Okay, that is the one way, right? Search database dbca database configuration assistant and put it over there. One, second, you can use it over here, start the command prompt, run as administrator, and over here you have to use simply dbca database configuration assistant. It will display the database configuration assistant sitting in front of you in few minutes or seconds. Okay, secondly, thirdly, you are having, click it over here on the start, search the all programs that we cited article 12c, and over here we are having the database configuration assistant. One of them, we are having three different ways to start the database configuration assistant. In database configuration assistant, we are having the different options are available to create database, configure database. We have already available database, we can delete it, manage the templates, and manage pluggable database. So first step, that is to manage the pluggable database. So select option is here, manage the pluggable database. If you want to create the container database, main database, so for that one, create database. At this stage, we are creating it over here, pluggable database. So select the option of manage pluggable database. Select this one, click it over here on the next. When we click next button, in the new screens, it will display the options. That's create pluggable database, unplug database, delete pluggable database, configure pluggable database. Like we are having already existing database is there, we can delete it. If you want to make change or configure that one, we can do it. At this stage, we are just creating the pluggable database. Options there, create pluggable database, and then click it over here on Next, we are having database. That is a container database. As you know that one container database may contain many pluggable database. So in our system, the name of container database, that is ORCL. That is a container database. In this container database, we are having, and when we are connected with SysTPA, means we are connected with the container database, then we can alter the session to move any pluggable database. So here our container database is ORCL. If that asks for the username and password, enter the username of sys and the password that you use it at the time of installation. If that is not asking for the username, we find with me, I use it over here, that is not asking for that one. So click over here the next. What? If that is asking the username and password, and you are not providing that one username password, it means that it will display the error message, right? So if system is asking for that one, then you have to provide the username and password over here. So for username, you have to use the sys and the password that you use it over here at the time of installation, right? So sign that one password. Click it over here, next button. Loading database information. What we have in the ORCL database? So all of these information will be displayed over here.
This is the error.
So it means that something is wrong with your database. You are using the wrong password over here, wrong usernames over here, or even if you are having the databases available in the previous options, if username password is okay, then it will never display the dead one option over here. Now we have to create the new database. We want to create the new database, pluggable database. But on that database, what we want? We want to add the sample database. Sample database are there. HR schema is available. SCOR schema. We want to use, add the simple user sample schema available. Then we want to add it over here. So for that one, we have to select the option of create pluggable database using PDB set file. Now here we have to select create pluggable database using PDB file set. Where we are having files, we are going to two type of files are available. Pluggable database meta file, and that one segment we are having the backup file, database backup file log files available. So we have to select here the pluggable database meta file. Why we are using? Reason is that one, whenever we are having the option is available over here, the pluggable database meta file, it means that where we are having the sample schema are available. Where we are having the sample schema are available. So click it over here on the browse button. It will display it over here the file. So where that one file is available, it see that we are having the file is available in app Oracle Home User Project 12.1 Oracle Home Assistant DBCA, and then we are having the template. We are having this one file is available. Which one file? We are having the file here, sample schema.xml. If you want to check it out where this one file is available, so for that one, simply click come over here and D drive app Oracle Home Users. Then we are having the product 12.1, this one. Then we are having next one option is here assistance, and in assistance we are having the options here DBCA database configuration assistant, and here we are having the option is here templates. In templates we are having the different types of files are available. So what are the files that we need over here? We need the file that is over here, that is a sample schema dot xml. This one file is available. When we select this one file, right, sample schema dot xml, this one file is selected, so it will automatically select it over here. Another file also, that is a backup file, sample schema dot dfb, data backup files, data file backup, right? So what we are using it over here, create pluggable database using PDB file set. in file set, we have to select the option of clicked over here browse, and in browse we have to select the option of simple schema dot XML, that is a metadata file, and second file, that is a backup file, is available over here, right? After that one, click it over here next button. It means that we are adding the simple schema over here, right? Now it will ask for the location we want to store, where we want to store it over here. Next one, database names. What should be the database names? Database names, that you see that we are having the database names, that is PDBORCL, and I am using it over here, PDBORCL4, right? If you are using create a new administrator, fine. If you are not using creating a new administrator, that will work properly. Database location here, app, Oracle home users, Aura data, Oracle, ORCL, and then over here, your PDB, ORCL, plus the database name will be displayed over here, right? So mention it over here, database names. Remaining store types, we are having two different types of storage over here. One is file system, we use it over here as it is. So click it over here on next. So when we click it over here, that will display the message database configuration assistant summary. We are having container database, the name of that database is ORCL, pluggable database PDB ORCL 4, and what is the location of that one? Here we are having D drive, app, Oracle home user, Aura data, ORCL, and the name of that one is PDB ORCL 4, right? When we click it over here on the finish button, it will start installing the our pluggable database. So click it over here, finish. So progress page. Now within few minutes that complete our task. It displayed over here creating the pluggable database, and that is in progress. Whenever installation of pluggable database is completed, after that once, what we have to do? We have to check it over here in the SQL plus, that one pluggable database is added over here or not. So connect with sysdba password and show PDBs. So it says that PDB ORCL pluggable database is available over here, and read write. If it displays the option of mounted, if database displays the option of mounted, so for that one you have to write the command over here to alter the database. Alter database, name of database PDB ORCL 4, and that is we want to make it over here read write. Open, read, write. So what we did over here, alter database, sorry, what we have database name is here, we are in pluggable database, sorry, alter pluggable database, name of database, open, read, write. So now,
sir, mounted.
When we are using the word mounted, like we are having the different status of the database are available. So for that one, we are having mounted or open. Mounted means you may not be able to perform all the operation over there in that one database. So here we are having already database is open. And simply you can use it over here, startup opens, right? So database will be open over there. Now here again I have the spelling mistakes are available. Alter, again I am writing it over here, pluggable. Database, name of database PDBORCL, and what we are having for read write open read write. If that is already open, then that's okay. Okay, it says that plugin database is already open, then fine. Now, after that one, what we have to do? We have to move to the TNS name.aura file, and over there we have to add this one pluggable database. The pluggable database PDB that is there, PDBORCL 4. So for that one, connect it over here in the app, Oracle Home Users, project 12.1.0 DB Home. We are having option of the networks and admins over here TNS name.aura. So here in this one file, copy this one ORCL, this one complete. Copy this one folder and paste it over here. And over here, the name of our pluggable database is here PDBORCL, and that is a 4. And service name also make the change over here PDBORCL 4. Save it over here. File save and then close it over here. After that one, what we have to do? We have to reload all of these services PDBORCL in the listeners. So for that one, connect with CMD and run it as a administrator. Yes, what we have over here, we have to use it over here lsnrctl listener control and reload. Listener control reload, it will display the message that your listener is reloaded. If you want to check the services of listener, so lsnrctl services, then it will display all the services. So it display it over here. Yes. Our container database name is here ORCL, then PDBORCL as one instance, then we are having PDBORCL 3, then we are having PDBORCL 2, PDBORCL 1, then PDBORCL. All of these services are available over here, right, in CMD. After that one, here we have to alter the position. We have to alter session set container is equal to PDBORCL 4. Now we are having pluggable database, that is a 4 is available over here. After this one, we want to check what are the different simple schema that are available over here or not. Previously we said we are having 36 different users that are by default added over there. Now let's see how many users. So for that one, select username from all underscore users. It will display all the user data available over here. So it added over here 43 different users, and here we are having the other user that we want to edit over here. Similarly, Scott user is also available over here. Scott user is available over here. BI users and other users are also available. So in this way, we can add sample schema as well as we can create the pluggable database. Now if you want to alter, now here for this one, we again we have to alter the HR schema. We have to alter the HR users, set the password and then other data over here. So for that one, alter user HR identified by HR account unlock. So it's a dead password of this one user is set it over here HR account, that is unlock. Now if you want to connect, so for that one, connect HR slash HR at PDBORCL 4. So for this one user, we can add it over here. Let's see if that is connected over here or not. So that is connected. Now in previous HR, that was available in another pluggable database, that was available in the PDBORCL. Now, over this one, HF schema is available over here in the PDB-ORCL 4. If you are having data merger, that is not available here in this one pluggable database.